Hello kids, now let us start the next chapter, quartic equation. Now this quartic equation you have come across in lower grade also, even in polynomials we have done that quartic polynomial. It is the same thing, only thing we'll be equating it to zero. Now what is the standard form of quartic equation? Standard form of quartic equation is given by ax square plus bx plus c is equal to zero. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, constant will be left hand side. So where a is coefficient of x square, b is coefficient of x, and c a constant term. That's all. So these are standard form. Now in this chapter we'll be learning to solve for x, to find the roots of quartic equation by different methods. Now what are those methods? Okay, hope this is clear, then just please. Okay. Now what are the methods of finding roots of quartic equation? Methods of finding roots of quartic equation. Now first method is factorization or middle term splitting method. Now all these methods you have learnt in 8th grade, 9th grade and all, you have learnt this. Last year also in polynomials you have learnt this middle term splitting method. It is the same thing, it is continued. Maybe you may come across big numbers, that's it. Second method is finding the roots by completing square method. Now whenever I start this method, very first thing the child will say is this method is not there in CBSE. They have cancelled this. No. You have to learn this because this is very important for higher grade. In higher grade, nobody will teach you all these methods at that time. Now the last method is finding roots by using quadratic formula. These are the three methods. Now I'll just brief you the factorization or middle term splitting method with few examples. Then we will. Okay, now the very first method we will see. I'll just take some simple examples. Now, x square plus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now you should find two numbers such that when you add, you should get the center value, the middle value. What is it? Plus 3. And the product of same two numbers should be the first and the last term. Product of first and the last term is 1 into 2, 2. So you have to choose two numbers such that when you add you should get plus 3 and the product should be 2. I will take plus 2 and plus 1. If you take plus 2 and plus 1, if you add we will get plus 3 and the product is plus 2. You should be careful with the sign. If there is minus even you should consider that. So x square plus, in place of 3x you are going to write as 2x plus x plus 2 is equal to 0. When now between first and second term take x as common, so you get x into x plus 2. Between third and fourth term take 1 as common, x plus 2. So x plus 2 into x plus 1 is equal to 0. So value for x will be minus 2 or minus 1. It is same as finding zeros in polynomial. So same way we are going to do. Now what is the meaning of this? Finding roots means in this equation if you substitute the value of x as minus 2 it will be 0. Or in the same equation, if you substitute minus 1 in the place of x, you will get answer 0. So, this is the meaning of it. Like, this is the meaning of roots. So, this is the first method. Now, after this, start solving. As in the solutions also, exercise continued by 4.1. Thank you.